Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Smoke Learning Channel. In the previous text videos, we looked at different text situations, including placing text on a path. This video will show you how to make credit rolls using the text tool. But we won't just make a basic roll. We'll also look at using styles, tabulation, and timing to get the roll looking exactly like you want. So starting in the sequence, I'm using a 5-second black color source as the basis for my credit roll. If you are superimposing the credit roll over an edit, you could use the gap effects shown in the previous videos. Now select the color source segment and press Ctrl Tab to bring up the effects ribbon. Choose the text timeline effects to apply it to the segment. Let's jump straight into the text editor to start the credit roll. Now, if you just wanted to make a static title as before, you can either click New Layer or just click the screen and a new layer will appear. However, this is not what we need. So delete any layers you may have created. To create a roll or crawl layer, you need to switch to the Roll and Crawl menu. Here you will find a menu to choose whether you want a roll or crawl. Set the menu to Roll and click New Layer. This will create a new text layer, but the distinct difference is that it has an animation scroll bar to the right of the text layer. This will help control the timing of the roll when it moves up the screen. Ensure the text layer is set to edit mode using the Escape keyboard shortcut. Now at this point, we can type our text manually, or we can bring text from another application. So not to bore you, I have a text file in the Text Edit application. Select all the text and press Command-C to copy it. Go back to Smoke and press Command-V to paste the text into the layer. Remember that if the layer was not set to edit mode, it would not accept the pasted text. The next step is to stylize the text to create a distinct difference between the job titles and the people's names. So I would like job titles like Starring, Script, and Directed By to be in one style, and the people's names in a different style. So to start, the way you define a style is to simply select some text, like this job title for instance. Now let's format the style of the text. Click the font field to enter into the font browser. Set the font type to true type. Now go into the system fonts folder. I'll choose Arial Narrow Italic. Press load to load the font onto the selection. Next, click the Fill Color Pot to change the color. I want all job titles to be in yellow. Finally, I'll change the paragraph alignment to the center of the margins. So this is the style for the job title credits. This is what I want, but please remember you can format the text any way you want. Now let's define this as the first style. Switch to the Styles menu. Here, you can store up to 9 styles at a time. You can also load and save style palettes if you're working on a series of campaigns. To define a style, click the Define Style button. Next, click the Style 1 button to place the style here. You can also name the style for clarity's sake. Click the Name button. Change the name to Job Title. Click the Style button to apply the name change. So that's the first style saved. Now select a line with the people's names. First, increase the font size to make the names bigger. Next, go into the font browser. Ensure TrueType is selected and go into the System Fonts folder. I'll choose Arial Bold for these credits. Press load and I have the final look for my name credits. Now I'll define this as a style again. Click Define Style. Click Style 2 to place the style there. I'll also click the Name button and change the name to People. Remember to click the button to apply the name change. Now you can go through and select various text and apply styles to them. What is useful to know that even after you've applied a style to text, you can still go ahead and adjust the look. For example, I will select the director's name and the bottom title and center the paragraph alignment. Next, I'll select just the bottom title and make it a bit smaller. So that's looking good so far. You'll obviously notice that I didn't center the other names. This is because I want to create text columns that you often see in features with very long credit rolls. In order to make these text columns, you will use Tabulation. Switch to the Tabulation menu. You will find Tabulation in most word processing tools. The first element to using Tabulation is the ruler bar above the text layer. This will show you the Tabulation markers and their alignment orientation. Secondly, Tabulation is selection-based. So you can select particular lines to contain tab markers, or you can press Select All to set the tabulation for everything. A good example is when you have to make two columns of names for the first section and then three columns of names for the second section. This is all in one credit roll. Next, under the tab header, press the Add button to place the first marker. The first position of this marker is 100 pixels in from the left-hand margin. You can adjust this value to set whatever positioning you want for your text. So I'll set the positioning to 400 pixels. For the second column, you would click Add again. By default, the second tab is placed 100 pixels away from the first. However, I want the second tab to be 400 pixels from the right-hand margin. The margin width has a length of 1536 in this HD frame. So I'll set the positioning of the second tab to 1136 pixels. This is the 400 pixels from the right margin. Now the tabs also contain justification. So the first tab justifies from the left. I'll select the second tab and justify it from the right. So each tab will contain its own alignment for the tabbed text. Now, starting on the first line of the people's names, press Tab once. Move the cursor to the second name in the first line. Press Tab again, and this will shift the name to the second tab and justify it to the right. Now go through the rest of the names and tab them into position. This means all my text is correctly aligned up, including any text columns that you need to create for an extended credit roll. So that's the text ready to go. Press Escape to ensure you toggle into move mode. To animate the roll, you turn on Auto Key. Go to frame 1. Using the scroll bar on the left, scroll the text downwards to the start of the roll. Now go to the last frame. Scroll the text all the way to the end. Turn Auto Key off. When you scrub the time bar, the roll is now animated. Exit the text editor. Depending on your hardware configuration, you might be able to play this back in real time. This will give you an idea of the rolling speed. Now this roll is moving too fast since it is only 5 seconds. So I would like to extend it to 10 seconds. Switch to the trim mode by pressing the R keyboard shortcut. Zoom out of the sequence so that you can see 10 seconds. Move the positioner to 10 seconds in the sequence. Before you perform any trim operations, change the keyframe options from shifting keyframes to repositioning proportionately. This means that as you trim the segment, the keyframes will stretch their timings to match. This actually works for all timeline effects animations and not just text. Select the tail of the segment. You could just drag the tail to the positioner, or press E to trim the tail to the positioner. The credit roll will now run at 10 seconds. Press Render to render out the credit roll with anti-aliasing, etc. So that is how you make a credit roll using the text tool in Autodesk Smoke. Remember that the actual rolling move is keyframeable. So for example, you can stop the move at the end to hold an end title. Just edit this through the animation curves. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.